Okay, it was a two-point game late in the fourth quarter, and then Rel kind of took over. You were part of it with the half-court assist. What's Rel like when he gets into that situation?
I mean, to Rel, he's a great point guard. I mean, he always finds his teammates when they're open, so just be ready to catch the ball.
It looked like he was just standing there trying to run some clock, but he found Dom on an alley-oop and then found you wide open and then drove the lane, and all of a sudden it's a 10-point game. What makes him do that kind of stuff?
I mean, I don't know. He just trusts his teammates. I mean, he's a great point guard.
Tell me about your fourth quarter. You normally come off the bench, but I think you gave them a great big spark in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, I know. Coach always says be ready, and then that's what I did.
How big is beating a team like City?
That's real big, because we ain't played them in so long, and we finally get a chance to play a big game. You ready to play?
Playing City and getting a run in like this, it's got to help you guys.
Oh, definitely. Especially this point in the season. Paul called me and asked me if I was willing to play a game out. And I knew twofold. I really didn't want to play against Paul, but yeah. I wanted to retire without playing him. But I was up for the challenge. And it's a good atmosphere to play in, because that's the way the playoffs is going to be, this type of atmosphere.
Midway through the fourth quarter, it's a two-point game. You call a timeout, spread the floor around. And Rel just kind of took over, even though he's standing still at the midcourt.
Right. He's the ball handler on the team, and he could do some good things with the ball. We really wasn't running plays. We were kind of just, like you say, we're spreading the floor. If we have opportunities to get to the basket, make the short pass, and then, you know, things just fell away. Rel did a good job of getting to the basket and finding people.
Talk about Reese a little bit. You move a lot of guys in and out of the lineup. He just seemed to be a spark for you in the fourth.
I mean, that's what we're looking for. Every time I call someone's number, I say, you always got to be ready. He was ready today. He made plays. He played good defense. Hit his free throws. And that's what I ask of him. If he can do that, you know, if I can call his number, he can do it. He stays in. You know, that's just how it goes. Some guys didn't play as much as they wanted to, but it's a team effort. We won as a team. So I got to put the best five guys out there.
First of all, playing against Jeff a little bit.
It's strange, but it's good. He did us a favor, right, by helping me schedule the game. And we need to play top-notch opponents. You're not going to get better, right, scheduling somebody that you know is a W, right? And obviously, this was not a W game. This was a challenge and a great game.
Two-point game in the middle of the fourth quarter.
Yes.
And they spread the ball around a little bit. Fell asleep a couple times on offense,
yeah,
and Terrell picked it apart.
Yeah, we did. Terrell's a nice player. He's quick. He can penetrate. He can find people. He's a nice player. And that's why we played zone most of the night, because I didn't think we could actually match up with him if we had to play man the whole game.
On balance, this going to help the team?
Yeah, I think so. You know, I don't think anybody in Central 1 is any better than that club, right? So that means that, you know, we're right knocking on the door of being a pretty good basketball team. But, you know, we got to cut down on the turnovers. Right? We were fine and basically in the first quarter, I thought, when they turned up the pressure a little bit, I thought we broke down a little bit, all right? We need to handle the basketball. Turnovers are worth 4 points, every single one of them. We had too many of them.